हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू दिशा क्लासेस। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू रेज्यूम आवर लर्निंग ऑफ सर्कुलेटरी सिस्टम थ्रू ब्लड वेसल्स। ओवरव्यू ऑफ द सब्जेक्ट। व्हाई हार्ट इज वाइटल ऑर्गन ऑफ द बॉडी। व्हाट इज द रोल ऑफ हार्ट। व्हाट इज ब्लड। व्हाट इज द फंक्शन ऑफ ब्लड। व्हाट आर द ब्लड वेसल्स। व्हाट इज द फंक्शन ऑफ ब्लड वेसल्स। इज इट नेसेसरी टू हैव ब्लड वेसल्स। इन दिस वी हैव स्टडीड द फर्स्ट टू in the previous class. Now we will be looking after all these things which are not discussed earlier. Blood vessels are important components of the circulatory system that transports the blood to all the parts of the body. This means blood vessels are the tubules which are the important components of the circulatory system, as they transport the blood to all the parts of the body and the tissues. These blood vessels will carry nutrients, oxygen along with the blood to all the parts of the body. With respect to it, they also take away the waste and carbon dioxide from all the tissues and parts of the body. Blood vessels are the tubules which will be flowing the blood from heart to the tissues and body parts. Along with it, they do also carry back the waste and carbon dioxide from different parts of the body and from the tissues to the heart. We call them as vessels because they are in tubular shape and they as a long narrow tubes which are connected to different parts of the body from the heart. Blood vessels play crucial role in the survival of the human body and in its functionality, as all the tissues will be relying on blood supply for its functions. They play crucial role, that is important. This also helps in functionality of the tissues and other parts, because without blood supply there won't be any nutrients and oxygen. Without them they could not perform any task for their livelihood or living. There are 5 types of blood vessels, namely arteries, arterioles, capillaries, veins and venules. They play a major role in the functioning of different parts because the blood supply will be done through these. Arteries takes the blood away from the heart through a branching system of arteries, which will end into arterioles, which are short narrow tubular muscles. Arteries will help in the flow of blood from the heart. These are in the branching systems, which will be end up into arterioles, which are narrow and muscular tubules. From the arterioles, the blood enters into simple endothelial tubes known as capillaries, which will exchange the gases and cellular nutrients from blood to the tissues. Arterioles are the small, narrow, muscular tubules which will help the blood to flow from arteries to capillaries. They play a major role between these two as a bridge. And capillaries are endothelial tubes, simple endothelial tubes which will be connected to the tissue and different body parts, which will help them to supply the blood for their systemic action. Exchange of oxygen waste products from tissues to the blood occurs through diffusion. From capillaries, the diffusion process takes place through which oxygen from the blood enters into the tissues and carbon dioxide from the tissues enters into the blood of capillaries. And then the nutrients and cellular molecules will be entered through diffusion process into the tissues, and waste products from the tissues will enter into the blood. The veins will carry the deoxygenated blood from all the parts of the body to the heart. The deoxygenated blood means the blood which consists of carbon dioxide will flow back to the heart through veins. The venules will carry the deoxygenated blood and waste products from capillaries back to the heart. In this picture, we can see the process of flow, that is, प्योर ब्लड विच कंसिस्ट ऑफ ऑक्सीजन विल फ्लो थ्रू आर्टरी एंड देन इट विल एंटर इंटू आर्टेरियोल्स एंड देन इंटू कैपिलरीज. हियर द डिफ्यूजन प्रोसेस टेक प्लेस एंड फ्रॉम हियर द ऑक्सीजन विल एंटर इंटू द टिश्यूज एंड कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड एंटर्स इंटू द ब्लड एंड सेलुलर मॉलिक्यूल्स एंड न्यूट्रिएंट्स एंटर इंटू द टिश्यूज एंड वेस्ट प्रोडक्ट्स एंटर इंटू द ब्लड एंड देन दिस ब्लड विथ कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड एंड वेस्ट प्रोडक्ट्स विल एंटर इंटू द वेन्यूल्स एंड फ्रॉम द वेन्यूल्स इट गोज टू द वेन्स एंड फ्रॉम वेन्स इट विल गोज टू द हार्ट. नोट, वेस्ट प्रोडक्ट्स विल बी एक्सक्रीटेड थ्रू स्किन इन द फॉर्म ऑफ स्वेट एंड थ्रू द अदर एक्सक्रीशन प्रोसेस. द वेस्ट प्रोडक्ट्स नॉट ओनली एक्सक्रीटेड थ्रू सर्कुलेशन बट ऑल्सो एक्सक्रीटेड थ्रू डिफरेंट प्रोसेस. We'll look into the anatomy of the arteries. As the arteries will supply oxygenated blood from hearts to all the parts of the body, so they have relatively thicker walls. The largest artery is aorta and the smallest is the pulmonary artery. Here we can see the external and the interior anatomy of the artery. Here we can see the external tunica. It is called as external because it is a outer surface, and below that there is an external elastic membrane. External elastic membrane is there because it will help in the elasticity of the walls, because when there is a high pressure of blood flow, it will sustain the pressure and avoid any kind of rupture to the walls of the arteries. Tunica media, the middle one between the external and internal, is called as tunica media. The internal elastic membrane, there are two elastic membranes, one is external elastic membrane and internal elastic membrane, and there is tunica intima. As it is an internal layer, it is also called as tunica intima. And there is the last one, an internal wall, is endothelium. The veins have thinner walls when compared to the arteries. They transport blood from all the parts of the body to the heart. As we have seen, the arteries, they have thicker walls, different layers, and now we are going to look after the veins. In this, the external layer is tunica externa, which consists of connective tissue and elastic fibers. Tunica media, which consists of smooth muscle and elastic fiber. And we can see the tunica intima, which is endothelium, and there will be a valve which will be avoiding any kind of backflow of blood or reverse flow of blood to the tissues or any other body parts. And there is a lumen, which is the internal most layer or the cavity, we can say, where the blood flows. The vein, which is at the end of the anterior end of right side of the heart, is known as superior vena cava or pre-caval vein. Please note that there are two names for the superior vena cava or a vein which carries deoxygenated blood from the anterior end of the body, that is superior vena cava and pre-caval vein. Do not forget the another name, as it collects the blood from the anterior end of the body. It is known as superior vena cava or pre-caval vein. It collects the deoxygenated blood from head, neck, chest and arms of the body. This is the superior vena cava. The vein which brings the blood from the posterior end of the body, that is from the abdomen and legs and other parts of the body except head, neck, chest and arms. That is, except from the parts from where the superior vena cava collects the body, collects the blood. From there, the cava will collect the blood. The vein is called as inferior vena cava or post-caval vein. This is the inferior vena cava because it collects the blood from the lower parts of the body. The superior vena cava or pre-caval blood from upper parts of the body and send it to the right atrium. Superior vena cava, as it is discussed, it collects the blood which is deoxygenated अपर पार्ट्स ऑफ द बॉडी एंड इट विल फ्लो थ्रू द आर्टरी सुपीरियर वीना सॉरी वेन इट विल फ्लो थ्रू द सुपीरियर वीना कैवा इनटू द रेट एट्रियम सुपीरियर वीना कैवा और प्री कैवल वेन विच कलेक्ट्स द डिऑक्सीजनेटेड ब्लड फ्रॉम द अपर पार्ट्स ऑफ द बॉडी विल डंप द ब्लड इनटू द रेट एट्रियम एंड द इन्फीरियर वीना कैवा और पोस्टीरियर वीना कैवा इट विल कलेक्ट द डिऑक्सीजनेटेड ब्लड फ्रॉम द लोअर पार्ट्स ऑफ द बॉडी विल डंप द ब्लड इनटू द राइट एट्रियम नाउ विल डिस्कस अबाउट द पल्मिनरी वेन एंड आर्टरीज दीज आर द एक्सेप्शन केसेस इन वेन्स एंड आर्टरीज विच मस्ट बी अंडरस्टूड केयरफुली पल्मिनरी वेन विच ओरिजिनेट्स फ्रॉम द लेफ्ट एट्रियम ऑफ द हार्ट इज कनेक्टेड टू द लंग्स इट विल कैरी ऑक्सीजनेटेड ब्लड फ्रॉम द लंग्स टू द लेफ्ट एट्रियम द पल्मिनरी आर्टरी which will originate from the right ventricle of the heart is connected to the lungs it will carry deoxygenated blood from the right ventricle to the lungs that is the pulmonary veins will carry the oxygenated blood from lungs to the heart see here left ventricle left pulmonary vein will collect the oxygenated blood from lungs to the heart and the right pulmonary artery will collect the blood from right ventricle and it sends to the lungs so that there can be a purification of blood okay